Previt, this is Salvation. I present to you Red in Fallout 4. We are in Vault 81. I am about that far from giving up on this entire endeavor. Not the endeavor of the Vault 81, not the companion, but the endeavor of not actually getting bitten up as a bad job, going back, getting Nick, and forgetting about the attempt to do this better. Okay, one down. Right. Right. How many more? Behind me. Okay, that went well. Okay, that went exceptionally well. Right. The thing is with the mole rats, as I said before, they carry this disease. Jumping at my own shadow. They carry this disease, and there is a cure which we are looking for. This is the entire reason of us being here.
I'm sure this whole thing is overblown, and Austin will be running around tomorrow.
Overblown or not, we have to do what we can for Austin.
I just don't know what I can do.
Neither do I, Priscilla.
Why him? He's just a boy.
He's going to be just fine. You'll see.
So apparently we can hear the voices from the main vault when we're in here. Let me go back and fetch Nick for a moment. That's all, because the thing is I need to be extremely cautious if I don't want to get bitten. I need to stop my companion from being bitten too. Actually, what does it matter if I have Nick here? Absolutely nothing at all. It's not like I'll need him later. I'll just leave him there. I have to walk it back anyway, I think. And if I don't, I don't think he'll be stuck down here, and if so, then I'll have a shorter path than if I have to go back and forth and back and forth and back and forth. Okay. Let's look at the terminal. Hydroponics observation station. The crop rotation implemented by the hydroponics manager has proven successful for supplying the vault with adequate food. We have not had to intervene, which has eliminated the risk that the vault inhabitants would discover the secret part of the vault. So far, they do not appear to suspect the true nature of the vault. The greenhouse would be a perfect place to introduce Class C4 and D1 viruses into the population, as well as potential cures should the disease get too virulent. I'm recommending installing hidden sprayers in the ceiling. Now, ain't that nice? Here's the deal, this entire thing is a fucking mess. Let me make a hard save because of reasons. I hear these guys.
Well, this is gonna be a joy for you. You get to nag me and I can't go anywhere.
Oh, real nice, Holt. Make this about you. Don't you think about anyone other than yourself? Your daughter could get sick like Austin, and you're whining about spending time with your family?
I have things to do. We don't have to hide away in here.
You're so busy, Holt. You have so much to do. Please, explain to Aaron why your needs are more important than her safety.
Just never mind.
Idiot.
Now there's a harmonious family. Another terminal. Depot observation station. The vault inhabitants have unexpectedly repurposed this room to be a kind of store for selling and repairing the possessions. It has allowed this observation port to record interactions between many of the vault citizens. This shop will become an important disease vector for spreading airborne class B2 viruses. It will also be valuable for observing the effects of disease on social and economic relationships. This room will become a backup treatment location along with the commissary, or however you say that. The primary will still be the clinic under the assumption that severely ill patients will all be taken there. I hear these nutcases, but I can't see them. Free war money. I hate you. Can you hear them too? Of course you can. I don't even want to know what that thing has. I'm a coward.
You and your staff are to make sure every resident remains under stringent medical observation.
Understood. But overseer.
No buts. This is for the good of the vault. We can't risk this pathogen spreading, Dr. Forsythe.
Yes.
How is Austin doing?
Has progressed quite rapidly. We need a way to stop it from spreading.
Then let's hope that outsider pulls through and gets us a cure.
Still no thingy. Overseer observation station. Although the chief scientist argued against an observation port in an overseer's office, it has turned out to be a boon. We are able to observe the political shifts in governance since the vault door was locked. When we do introduce viruses to the population, we will be able to monitor the leadership's reaction and courses of action. Any chance I can trigger your spawn again? Shoot some more of you fellows before you get to me. Damn you. Nah, I don't like that. Try it again. Where are these things? I hear them. I don't think I have an actual choice than to go down there, don't I? Do I mean? Let me save and try that. Where are you? There's one. I'm making a hard save again because I don't trust the game. Oh my god, I'm so scared. Who's still running around in that ridiculous dress? Not that that really makes any difference, as far as I know. I see you. Okay. Okay, this is where I came from. This is where I'm going. Okay, still safe. Terminals are broken. Hang on, I have a level. Now, since endurance seems to do something for you in this particular vault, in this particular area, I'll put 1 point in there. Let's unlock that. 3. No, yeah, there's still 3. And I don't know which. No, is there another one? Yes, this one is also. Damn. This too?
Yes.
Remote door control, open door. Huh? Okay. I am not sure what this is. I don't think I had this ability back then. No, I definitely didn't have this ability back then. Hi? I thought there was more.
Busted.
Oh, another stranger. Are you Voltec Security? I've waited so very patiently for you to arrive.
Who the heck are you?
I am a Contagion's Vulnerability Robotic Infirmary Engineer, or CVR-IE. The human scientists call me Curie. Or more properly, they call me this when they were alive. I repeat, are you Vol-Tec Security?
These mole rats carry a disease. Do you know anything about it?
My poor little darlings. They were used to grow all manner of new and interesting pathogens. Then Vault citizens would be exposed to these viruses in the hopes that they would develop new antibodies. But they never got a chance to execute their plan. Clyde got out of his cage. He was smarter than the others. My sweet Clyde. He let out the others, and those poor scientists never stood a chance. Mm-hmm. Clyde's been dead for almost 2 centuries now, but his descendants have free run of the Vault. I'm rambling. Where are my manners? Are you Vault-Tec Security?
Yes. Yes, I am.
Superb! I placed an emergency call so long ago. I was beginning to think something dreadful must have happened. I am pleased to report I completed my primary duties 83 years ago. Thousands of pathogens were grown in the mole rat hosts. Then a single broad-spectrum cure was developed to treat them all. Very satisfying work for many decades. Now, please tell me you are authorized to release me from the lab.
I am so authorized. You are released.
Superb. I had almost given up all hope of living here. I'll open the door for you.
Oh, thank you so very much.
Since you are a Vault-Tec representative, I entrust you with the broad spectrum cure I developed. If you have an equivalent to my digital Hippocratic Oath, please use it quickly to prevent any undue suffering. However, be advised, there is only one dose left, and I can no longer make any more. If that is all, I am most eager to leave.
Bingo.
Okay, soon. Soon, Curie.
You only have one dose?
That is correct. There used to be more, but they all expired. Sadly, the organic compounds necessary to make more have all deteriorated.
You're just giving me the cure?
My primary responsibility is to obey the orders of specified Vault personnel, even if those orders violate my ethical matrix. But since you have graciously discharged me of this duty, I can give you the cure without directly disobeying my previous order. And if you happen to use the cure to save a life, then this is just a happy coincidence, no? Hopefully now I can properly further my scientific research. Since my job here is done, I think I will follow you out.
You will have to wait a moment for that, dearest. Terminal. Vault 81 mission statement from Vault-Tec Board of Directors, Chief Scientist, Vault 81 Medical Lab Petition. We are entrusting you with a mission that is critical to all humanity. Vault 81 will be used to wipe out diseases as we know them in the human race. Your petition of the Vault has been equipped with state-of-the-art medical research equipment, including the new Contagion's Vulnerability Robotic Infirmary Engineer, aka Curie. There is a century's worth of biological and chemical supplies. There are the genetically adapted mole rats and, most important, a vault full of test subjects. As with all great progress, the needs of the many outweigh the needs of the few. You will be infecting the people of the vault with diseases in attempt to have them develop antibodies. Some may not survive, but you must ensure that the breeding population is always maintained. It will take many generations, but with proper procedures you should be able to develop a disease-resistant group of humans. Your work will be the work of generations. Each generation of scientists must select the chief scientist. Curie will make sure that each reads this mission statement to keep the vault focused over the centuries. We wish you the best of luck. Now there's that craziness. There is more crazy here. Curie's terminal. Research. Date of the last data purge. Something. Memory failure. This terminal is not recommended for research backups. Please use hard copies. Personal. Initializing greetings laboratory. I have been ordered by Dr. Collins to add an entry to this terminal. Dr. Collins was most insistent that this is my terminal. I explained several times that robots cannot own property as per of co-policy, but his orders were most clear in this instance. I will comply with Dr. Collins' wishes and maintain a log when ordered to. Colleagues, I have completed my analysis and integration of the data to make a capable research assistant. I have been commanded to provide an assessment of my colleagues. Dr. Flint is objectively brilliant, although Dr. Collins repeatedly calls him brusque. But I find Dr. Flint's commands and speech patterns easier to pass. His observations are always very astute, and I am learning much about working with the cell cultures from him. Mr. Barrow is perfectly acceptable to work with. He performs mental tasks with my programming, which my programming is perfectly suited for, such as carrying heavy lab equipment. This is strange because my capabilities for such a task are far beyond those of a human male. I'm told by Dr. Collins that this is a sign of respect that Monsieur Barrows is making. This does not compute. Error in cache integer. Yes, obviously. Distress. Whatever. Unusually agitated state, he would not leave his quarters after his morning meal. Dr. Collins assures me the state is temporary and that Monsieur Barrow is merely overwhelmed with the whatever. Station, probably. Error in cache, again. Eulogy. Dr. Barrow is deceased. Postmortem indicates that he expired from a severe cardiac arrest brought on by advanced age. He died at 4:01 a.m. shortly after waking. In accordance with the doctor's pre-existing orders, the body was cremated and placed in this specified urn alongside Dr. Collins and Flint. Dr. Barrow was of great assistance in continuing the work left to us by the others. My last order was to continue working on our projects alone so that our deaths will not be in vain. My processes are fully committed to furthering the study of pathogens and viruses for the betterment of mankind to honor his last requests. Message ends. Collins Archive. Boot up. We hamstrung with only 3 researchers. Decided to make a few modifications to this Mr. Handy robot. Should be really useful for speeding up some of our lab work. I've been pretty anxious since admittance day. As if the world ending wasn't enough, I'm very concerned about Olivette's motives. Dusting off some of my old robotics chops has been just the distraction I needed. Personality profile. I've decided to write a suit of custom personality settings for the robot. She's a little bit of a Liza. I really hope she got into her vault down in DC, and a little bit of my grand school fling from Versailles back in 46. I'm loading her databanks with every great body of work I've access to here. Kant, Einstein, Born, Darwin, Curie, Faraday, Turing, Brown. She'll have so much to learn. It's already made her feel so much more like a peer in the lab as opposed to an appliance. I'm calling her Curie. I know. I was never a subtle man. Therapeutic. Curie's been doing great. Flint's finally stopped treating me like a crazy person for insisting we address her as a human, and I swear Barrow is deferential to her in a way that reminds me of seeing him around Rebecca back during the drills. It's actually endearing to see. Most importantly, and perhaps most surprisingly, she's bringing a sense of normalcy to the lab, keeping us all a bit more grounded. Anything to keep our minds off the situation we're in is all too welcome. I've tuned her personality matrix a lot, but it's beginning to feel wrong to manipulate her. I'm going to leave her programming alone for now and just see how she evolves as she keeps learning more. Ongoing directive. Haven't touched this terminal in years, not since I gave it its Curie as her own. Seeing her reaction to having something of her own was transformational. It just seemed wrong to violate that, and so it's truly been for her eyes only ever since. This final entry is an exception, and I suppose it's being written out of habit as a man used to a lifetime of recording his experiments. We lost Flint today, and Barrow has to spend more time helping me around the lab than actually performing research these days. So if only to report my findings, Curie has been a remarkable success. She transcended my expectations of robotic programming. Her personality feels as genuine as my own. Her interest in scientific research is insatiable, and seeing her struggle with concepts like mortality has been completely moving. Truly, she is my greatest work. I only hope that one day she can see more of the world. If only I could be there to witness her reaction to the blue skies and butterflies she's only heard me sing about. Now, this is really very sweet, actually. Hi, Curie. Get out of my way. Out of my way, I said. Let's leave. What do I need to do? Why is this? Is this an exit? Game, are you telling me this is a bloody exit? Curie? Well then, don't. She'll be there. And so will be Nick, I suppose. Yes, hi.
Psst, go on.
Let's go.
Good plan.
Oh my god, I managed it. I am not going back there. There may be another terminal I can listen into. I don't give a shit about it. I just want to be out of Vault 81. This is really terrible. Okay. I'm alive. Elevator door requires terminal. The fuck?
What is it?
I have no idea where I'm going, that's it. Remote door control, open door. Okay, okay, I'm here. That's... Wow, okay, okay. We have no mole rat disease, we have...
If you're looking to do some trading, look for the depot.
Yeah, I don't care right now, thanks. We have no mole rat disease because we can. There is a cheat, but I wouldn't have used it if I had not managed it so smoothly. Now, I would not have done it. I wouldn't. I would have stuck with a stupid disease which only reduces 10 health points and would have been done with it. But things are fine. I do not need to do this. The disease is the cure. There is only one of them, and
I wouldn't give for some real time off.
Yes, and. And
we got a barber here if you need it.
I don't need a bloody barber, I need to find my fucking way. Oh my god. Okay, okay, okay. I found a shortcut. I didn't find the shortcut last time. There's a broodmite of the old mole rats, and that's a real tough battle because this fucking creature is attacking me left, right, and center. Where's Nick? Come on, Valentine. I want you to witness this. You and Kiri both. Nick Valentine.
Hey, where are you going? Austin needs that cure.
Yes, and I need Nick.
I have been trapped so many years. I believe it's customary to thank you for your role in saving me. My entire life has been in this vault. I have analyzed and learned everything there is to know here. So now I must see the rest of the Commonwealth. Consult with scientists, unearth more data to challenge my hypothesis.
What are you looking to learn up there?
Down here is an enclosed system, and without the introduction of new mutagens, viruses, or bacteria, it is quite dull, medically speaking. The world up there is infinitely more complex. Who knows what diseases can be found and studied?
After the bombs, the Commonwealth is a little lacking in the science department.
But surely there is still men of learning out there.
Yeah, an institute.
And if nothing else, there is data. I can see you already have company. I do not wish to intrude. But I must ask. Please, madame, can you take me with you?
It's no picnic up there. Anything you can do to help us survive?
But of course. I have been equipped with medical equipment. If you become injured in our journeys, I can administer steam packs. I also have defensive capabilities, a laser. But surely there's little reason to use that.
Come along, then.
Excellent. We must embark at once.
So, Abby, hey, where are you going? Austin needs that cure.
Yes,
Nick.
Time to hit the road?
You interested in traveling together?
Sure, could be fun.
Let's head out.
Well, all right.
You are a scientific marvel, Monsieur Nick.
I'll let her stay here for the moment.
So have you decided to turn over the cure?
How is Austin doing? Do you think he'll survive the cure?
He's been unconscious since shortly after you left.
Here. Take the cure and use it on the boy.
Only one dose? I hope this works. If it doesn't, there won't be anything to analyze to try again. Let's hope this works.
I heard you had returned.
It's good that they are both here. Curie, where exactly are you
going? Let me ask you something.
Is something wrong?
Well, I sort of had the same question. It's just, with everything that's happened with you and your family, it's a whole hell of a lot to process. I wanted to make sure you're holding up all right.
Later.
Our visitor from the Commonwealth saved your life.
Really? Thanks, ma'am.
I was worried to death about you, Austin.
What got into your fool head?
going into a place like that.
Nothing exciting ever happens here. I just wanted to see what was in there.
Well, if it hadn't been for our friend here, you might have died. Thank you. I know you made sacrifices to help.
Not really.
I know Dr. Pinsky will be grateful. For my part, I'd like to give you the syringer. I had it for years and never really had a use for it.
She's not the only one. The whole vault is thankful. I'd like to give you a room here in the vault. A place you can call your own. It's in the main hall. On the left, as you get off the elevator. Once again, thank you.
I
hope you enjoy your accommodations. I wanted to say thank you again for what you did for Austin. You've opened a lot of eyes around here, including my own. I had no idea of the dangers Vault-Tec had hidden away so close to home. I can't believe so many died just behind our walls.
Done? Done.
Hey.
Hey. Let me ask you something.
Is something wrong?
Well, it's a whole hell of a lot to process. I wanted to make sure you're holding up all right.
Why do you ask?
I just had a hard go with the transition myself. Took me a long damn time to get a feel for this place. Thank goodness I found Diamond City. It's got its flaws, sure, but it beats the hell out of anywhere else in the Commonwealth. Of course, when I took up there back when, people were just as scared of the Institute as they are now. Maybe more. The massacre of the CPG was still pretty fresh in people's minds at that point. And folks were still losing sleep over the broken mask. Plenty of people assumed I was just a saboteur, moving in to melt down the reactor or poison the drinking water. But at the time, they couldn't exactly turn me away.
Broken mask?
This was long before I'd moved to town, but apparently some gentleman type shows up in Diamond City, heads down to Power Noodles. Guess he didn't like the food because he pulled his pistol and opened fire on the folks enjoying theirs. When security finally put enough holes in him to drop him, they say he was full of servos and sprockets. Just like yours truly. Seems he malfunctioned, went berserk. It was the first time people realized that synths had stopped looking like me and started looking like them. Considering what these folks went through, I felt real lucky they let me in the front gate at all.
Massacre of the CPG? What's that?
The Commonwealth Provisional Government. Years back, a group of settlements tried to get together and form a coalition. Every settlement with even a hint of clout sent representatives to try and hash out an agreement. Only the Institute sent a representative of their own, a synth. The man killed every rep at the talks. The Commonwealth Provisional Government was over before it even got off the ground. I took up in town not long after. I was damn lucky they didn't just tell me to scram right then and there.
Why'd they let you in?
Because I'd rescued the mayor's daughter. Gal of about 15. Pride and joy of the mayor back then. Man by the name of Henry Roberts. The young Miss Roberts decided she'd run off with some caravan hand she'd, known for an evening. Turns out the guy was part of a gang of kidnappers. I didn't even know who I was rescuing, just stumbled on a crying girl and four toughs. I took her home and the mayor dubbed me a hero, offered me a place in town. Lots of folks protested and said I was a spy, but he wouldn't have it. Taking up in the city was tricky at first, but I never tried to hide what I was, and people seemed to warm to that.
You took down four guys by yourself?
Well, I didn't have to. Back then, synths were even more of an unknown quantity than they are today. I told them I was rigged to explode and started going beep, beep, beep. Hardest part of that rescue was keeping from laughing as they climbed over each other to get away.
You're not a spy, right? Testing, testing. Hello, Institute, can you hear me? Hello.
Hell if I know. If I am, the Institute's plan to gather intel on all the runaways of the Commonwealth has been going off without a hitch.
Was it hard, settling in?
Yeah, they sure didn't make it easy. I started off doing the jobs no one else wanted. I got more banged up being Diamond City's handyman than I ever did living out in the ruins.
But I guess folks never forgot I rescued the mayor's daughter, so they started coming to me when people went missing.
Wife runs off with a new paramour and takes the rent money with her, Talk to the synth. An upset father decides moving him and the kids to Good Neighbor in the dead of night's not the worst damn idea since the bomb. Go get Nick.
After a while, the jobs got so backed up, they didn't even ask me to do the handyman stuff anymore.
Hell, I was so happy to do it, it was months before I started charging anyone. I never stopped being Nick the Synth, but it was Nick the Detective folks came to see. It was about then that things finally started feeling normal. It took me a long time to realize that home is where you make it. And with some time and effort, this place can be home for you, too. That's a long story, but I hope it helps. Want to get moving?
Alright, let me quickly find Curie again and then end this. If I can find her. I think she drifted up here, didn't she? Oh hell, where do I find this kid?
Now, where did I put those screws?
Do you wear your vault suit in the Commonwealth? Or just when you visit us?
I wear it. Where are
Remember,
you, Curie?
No funny business. I can't believe Austin almost died. Hard to tell by looking at him.
No, he must. She must. He? She must be somewhere.
Don't try anything.
I'm not trying
Aaron
anything.
Told me
it's
how you
a
saved
funny Curie.
Life. I guess you're not there for an outside.
Everything's under control.
Okay, I haven't the faintest idea where she went.
Heard we got a pretty big mess to look into now. You know, with that new vault.
Where the hell did she drift?
If you need fixing up.
You know what? I think I'll end this now and look for her in the next installment. Maybe I can see where she drifted off to.
Can't believe we had mole rats in the walls.
Yeah.
Yes.
You also have a bot somewhere and I can't find her. You have a lot of stuff going on that you don't know about.
Your Pip-Boy ever act up on you?
The only thing that's acting up on me is this stupid robot.
I see that vault suit of yours is still holding up.
Curie here?
Please direct any maintenance request.
Oh, it's Curie!
Hey, I heard what you did for Austin. You saved that kid's
okay.
life, so I was hoping you could help me out with Bobby. I need
someone
know what? To get him off the jet.
What the hell? Don't walk away when I'm talking to you!
I'll come back. This was Savasia and Red in Fallout 4. Bye-bye.